In this video, I'll show you how to do a literature search in Cochrane Library. Cochrane Library is a great supplement to the other videos that I've created that show you how to search resources like PubMed and Embase, because Cochrane publishes very high quality systematic reviews. Similar to our other resources, you want to start on the Medical Library website and then choose Library Resources. You can then type Cochrane Library into the search box and click Apply. You'll now see the link to enter the Cochrane Library database. Similar to our other databases, if you're off campus, you'll be prompted to sign in via Open Athens. Make sure you click on Florida Atlantic University, and then sign in with your FAU NetID and password. I've already done that, so I'm now logged in and can search Cochrane Library. You can type in a keyword here, or you can click on Advanced Search if you want to try to get a little bit more advanced. I will warn you that this is a very specialized database that will search all the Cochrane Library systematic reviews and clinicaltrials.gov. So if you try to get too advanced in your search, if I click here on Advanced Search and add a lot of specific elements, there might not be a systematic review published by Cochrane on your exact topic. So I do recommend going a little bit more broad here. So for example, a topic I know some people have been investigating is vaccine hesitancy. So I can start out with something broad like this and search. And it's showing me that there are four systematic reviews published by Cochrane that I could look through. Improving vaccination uptake among adolescents, factors that influence patients and inform caregivers' views. To view these systematic reviews, I just click on the title. And I can download the PDF full text. And it does give you options about the full content, the standard, or just a summary. The Cochrane reviews are quite long. Sorry, we'll ignore this pop-up. So you might want to start with a summary and then look at the full review as well. It will also show you if there's any related trials. It's pulling this information from clinicaltrials.gov, so it kind of saves you the search of also having to go to clinicaltrials.gov to search. You can look and see what trials have been registered with the government. It gives you an abstract, and you can also link out and see on clinicaltrials.gov to learn more about the trial that was conducted. This one, recruitment is completed. It was first posted in 2012 and last updated in 2017. This one doesn't have any results posted. Perhaps it didn't finish. It says it was completed in 2014. You have to look at each trial to see exactly what happened and what information there is about the trial. If you have a broader topic, like if you searched hypertension, you would probably get results for some of these protocols and clinical answers, because we would have much more out there because it's a bigger topic. So this was a very short introduction to Cochrane, but I just want to get across it's incredibly helpful for finding systematic reviews on a topic that have been published by Cochrane. They're one of the highest quality publishers out there doing systematic reviews. And you can also cross-search clinical trials at the same time. This is a good way to find something we call gray literature, which are things that maybe that haven't necessarily been published yet formally in a journal, but are maybe ongoing trials, or perhaps someone did a conference presentation on it. People tend to only publish positive results, and you don't want to miss something that could be helpful just because it wasn't published because the results weren't positive. As always, if you have any questions, please reach out to the medical librarians. We are happy to help you.